thing, but it's still French. Mostly. Yeah, I kind of feel bad for them. The language never continued to grow. It never continued to evolve. It didn't continue to do anything. It stuck where it was. But technology stuff has changed and the world has changed. And so it is a very smooshy language because pizza is pizza. There isn't an equivalent. But in true French, you would have a separate word for it. So it's a little confusing. I do love my French cousins, but they're weird. I need to find stuff to do with peaches. Oh, no, that's the fish box. I don't want the fish box. I want the spices box. We don't have enough to sell. Yeah. But yeah, studying is important. I think we want the fridge. I could be wrong, though. Oh, nope, I am not wrong. And it doesn't have to shift. Yay! Remember when we were baking these for my husband? And no, we were making them for Gust. And it's terrible because we didn't have enough. And now here I am floating in them. There is somebody standing over here. Oh no, I don't know what they're doing. Maybe it's my husband? Come on, resources. It's the rest of the cotton. Okay. How are you doing for wheat? You have none because you are not using the wheat. This guy. All I can say about him. This guy. Okay, we have too many. No more cotton. I need to put some of this stuff somewhere, and I don't know where to put it. Like, I should really put that in the spice one. But since I grow it here, it has to go here. And that's linen. I'm going to put that in the trees box. Problem is, the trees box is just a little box. It's not very big. I have a lot of trees. And they should be dropping the new our Spanish, Russian, Ukrainian. Yes. We have that issue here with anybody from the Caribbean and Jamaicans. Everybody just assumes that if you're from the Caribbean, if you're West Indian of some sort, you must be Jamaican. And it's like, no. My heritage is Barbados. I've never been to Jamaica. I know maybe two Jamaicans in my entire life. So, nope. My aunt is Jamaican. So technically, I guess I know her two sons because she had two sons when she married my uncle. So I guess that they are Jamaican as well. So I know three. Woohoo! But I know about 100,000 Bajans and Trinidadians and Guyanese and Puerto Ricans and not Puerto Ricans. I was going to say Trinis, but I don't know if you guys know what that is. People from Trinidad and Tobago. I know people from all the islands. But really and truly, those from Jamaica are the ones I know the least. That actually looks really bad there. This does not, it doesn't translate properly. I took something off this shelf, didn't I? Hi, husband. I'm going to take that off and put that on and see if it actually looks better. Oh, it does look better. All right. It looks better there. And then on here, I'm going to put that there. No, that does not look good. No. Cancel? My husband comes home and I start deadlifting furniture around. Yeah. Russian is one I really, 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 really want to learn. That is one I find a very beautiful language. I absolutely adore it. Yeah. I have a friend from Belarus, and he used to read me Shakespeare in Russian. Because I love Shakespeare. And I was like, wow, Shakespeare should have always been in Russian. It sounds so much better than it does in Shakespeare in English. That is such a beautiful picture. There, I just... Oh! Oh! Oh my. I actually don't know what I'm doing. Escape. Okay. Let me get back into here. Alright, I went to do a print screen, but I haven't been taught how to use my new screen capture for a print screen. Is he getting out of bed? No. So I just confused myself. The whole screen went gray and... Yeah, I had no idea what was going on. So today is Saturday. We go do the inspection, and then we head straight over to the mine. After we get our mail. Because the wonderful things it does. Oh! Oh, we wanted the tempering liquid. I remember. A little confused there for a moment, but okay. See you guys. Now. Yeah, they looked identical there for a moment. Russian and Ukrainian? Oh my gosh, they are kind of at war with each other. Like, totally. They hate each other. Well, they don't hate each other. The Ukrainians hate the Russians. There's a whole geopolitical thing that goes on with the two of them. It's pretty kind of ugly. Yeah. It's like the Greeks and the Macedonians. I don't know what the difference is, but holy moly. Like, don't get that one wrong. My dad had a client when he was working, because he's retired now. And, yeah, he was Macedonian. They're actually having an election right now to rename themselves the Republic of Macedonia. I was like, oh, okay. But not knowing or understanding anything about the conflict. Yeah, I said there was something wrong with that. I have no idea what was wrong with that. That was a series of just random, let's hit it and see what happens. That was kind of fun. Yeah, there was nothing wrong there either. You gotta got a chunk missing. There. There. Hey, Priestley. I am awesome. Thank you for asking. I had a good night's sleep. Weirdly enough, I woke up dreaming of Warframe. Those are weird days. Woohoo! Alright, let's go mining. I want more parts. Lots and lots of parts. Alright, so to get there takes a while, so we're actually going to take the DD transit. Hey, Sonya. And we're going to take it because we just built one. It takes us right up to there. I don't know how he drives across this little bridge, but he seems to do it. And I'm not going to argue with him because you don't argue with the driver when they're driving. Not considered safe. But while we're here, you know what else are here? Strawberries! Why is there only a partial tree here? Was I chopping this down and didn't finish my chop? Or why can I run on top of it? All right, we have to do a strawberry run first because what's the point of doing this if there are no strawberries? Strawberries, strawberries, strawberries. Hey, we can get all the way up here now. We couldn't do that before either. Ooh. Okay, glass wall. Nice. Was he on sale? Or... No, I like waking up with those dreams. I have woken up with my old job dreams, which are not so nice. But there are quite a few different old jobs that I had. Yeah, they've really changed how this looks. You used to be able to walk way down there. But not anymore. It also means the cinnamon tree that was there is gone. Which kind of makes me sad. And the crocs that used to be here are also gone. And these are spread out a little more. They used to be like really on top of each other. Go. I do know that when I was a child, one of the things that I used to do was I could never tell if it was morning, like, and I'd be dreaming of school, and I couldn't tell if it was real school or not really school. So I would sit up in my bed and I would sleep sitting up because I didn't want to lay down on the floor and then wake up and discover I was at school laying down on the floor. So I figured the lesser of the two evils was I'd rather sleep sitting up, which led to very bad sleep. Very, very bad sleep. But I didn't ever get caught sleeping on the floor at school. Mind you, I did put my head down and just zonk right out in school because I was so tired. Yeah, it's good to get sleep when you're in school. It's good to get sleep, period. All right, I'd like to go mining, please. Oh, has it really been that long? We paid $600 for a single day. You talk to people in your sleep? I don't know if I do. Nobody's ever told me if I do. Takbak could tell us. But I don't know if I want him to tell us. I talk in my sleep. I know he does. I can have whole conversations with him. It is awesome. It's a little confusing, but it is pretty awesome. He apologizes in his sleep. I'm like, you're Canadian. And you don't even know it. Things like if he turns over and he dead arms me, I'm like, ow, that hurts. And he'll be like, oh, I'm sorry. I'm like, don't be sorry. Just don't try to kill me in your sleep. And in the morning, I'll be like, yeah, you're so polite about it. And he's like, what are you talking about? You have no idea what you're talking about. And he has none. He's had a whole conversation, and he has not even a clue. Okay, so that was a gear, advanced engine. You know what? I am actually going to go after the gear. I can't remember if we can make them or not. What's over there? Oh. Does not matter. It says diving helmet. I'm in. Oh. There is... I don't know why it thinks that that is a sexual content. That is annoying. And I don't know how busy Tackback is, so... Let me put myself in inventory. There. And back out again. There we go. All better. He got a new toy, which I actually kind of like. Because I play a lot of games in which I have to take myself out of the game to be able to do stuff like that. And I was thinking, if I had one, it means that I wouldn't have to take myself out of the game. I don't know which piece to go for first. I guess the tempering liquid. It's right there. I could just press the button and it would possibly allow it. I have to find that from him. But money is going to be short for Christmas, so I don't know if I want to do that. It allows him to do a lot of things that I would really like to be able to do. I know we looked at it before. I think it's called a stream deck. And it's an interesting piece of tech. He's probably falling off his chair now going, she really wants to get some? Oh my gosh. It's like, yes, I know. It's shocking sometimes. But the prices come down dramatically on it. Oh, the other thing is my printer died. My printer very rudely decided that after 7 years past its expiry date, that it was no longer going to work. Now, it can be repaired. Unfortunately, since it is a 10-year-old printer, the parts are actually not... You can't find them. Like, they're just... They don't exist. Nobody has the pieces for a printer that is this old. Like, it's just not doable. And I'm like... And then I went on YouTube to look at, well, if I could find the part, can I repair it myself? And after watching that, I was like, it would be far easier to take my car apart and rebuild the engine than it will be to replace the printer head on my printer. Yeah, and that's the thing. When I got it, they made these printers to last forever. And it did. It was incredible. so I am duly saddened. And I was like, of all the things that could go wrong with it, it's called the F4 error. And that is essentially like the screen of death, the blue screen of death on a computer. It means that the print head itself, like the actual little tiny piece of it, has shorted out. So you have to replace the entire thing. Ancient computer. Parts and parts. So yeah, you have to actually replace the head. They had other suggestions, like letting it cool down because it's burnt out, or, you know, do other things with it to get it to fix it and stuff. But it's not really recoverable. I did let it sit and I did let it cool down to see if I could get it to come back. The fault is mine. I had to replace the blue ink, and I didn't want to replace the blue ink because I wasn't using the blue ink, and you have to buy the color packs in packs of three. Well, I had enough of the other two colors, so I said, all right, I won't color anything with blue. I'll just, you know, stick to black and white, or I will stick to, you know, the other colors and work from there. Yeah, that's a good theory. Not such a good reality. Because it still means that the head of it has to be used in some way. So with no ink from there, it just overheated and fried itself. Which means my beautiful printer could have still been working if I had just sucked it up and bought more ink. Yeah, that's what Dad was saying. You have to watch out because the problem with a lot of these printers nowadays is that the replacement ink is more expensive than the printer itself. And so that's what I've been really looking at, is how much... Like, I have found another printer that I really kind of like. It is an older printer again. So I of course, like that because I prefer the older ones. They are... I don't know. As far as I'm concerned, they have a better temperament. And they were built to last. What's the other piece that's behind me? Okay, parts. Good. So I want to... go. So I want to get something that's going to last me a while. I do a lot of printing. Like an awful lot of printing. One of the committees that I'm on right now, I only have 8 left, so let's just... Oh, there we go. One of the things that we do is we have a Syrian family that's coming here, and we have to outfit everything in their home. So we're looking, like my part of the committee is looking after all the household goods. So when we're doing the household goods, it means that we need to have a list of everything you have in your home. And we say everything, we mean the art on your walls, the carpets on your floors, the toothpicks in your toothpick holder, everything. So all said, when that list is printed out, it's about 15 pages or so. And we're going through multiple drafts of it. And there are 3 people on our committee. So we need to have that many. Plus, we need to have a copy for everyone. It is quite horrible, the amount of paper we go through. The printer I had didn't do double-sided. You had to feed the page back in again to be able to do it. And that is kind of a problem when... Oh, I got more mail. Oh, this is going to be the workshop rankings, isn't it? Oh, no. Yeah. Thank you. And so it's a bit of a problem. Hey, Nora. Oh, because you have to feed it in. And sometimes you don't know which way to feed it in. So I'm looking for a printer that does double-sided. Well, seems that most of them do that now. That's kind of normal, which is awesome because I would like to do that and I can save a lot of paper. The one I'm looking at right now is still compact. It is a Brother because I really like the Brother ones. And I have to check the ink. It has an oversized reservoir, it's called. So the reservoir on it is supposed to be significantly bigger than the one that is normally found with printers. So it should print a lot more pages. So I don't mind if my printer ink is $100, as long as it prints, you know, 100,000 pages. If it won't print as many as something else that the printer costs less or the ink costs less, then I'm like, eh, I'm out. So that's my project for later today, is to sit down and do a cost effectiveness on it. I still would like to have, and it sounds terrible, I would still like to have a fax function. It is going to be an all-in-one. It has to be a printer, a scanner, and a photocopier. I don't want just a printer to print. I want it to do all of that. You know, if I'm going to put the money out for it, it better have all the bells and whistles. I'm finding a lot of them right now. What they have is... they have a lot of strange stuff that I don't know what they are. Like, apparently I can cloud print. I'm like, why do I need to print clouds? Like, I have no need to print clouds. I'm about to run out of time, and I have no idea what's wrong, and my magnifying glass will not magnify. Okay, that's wrong. All right, the magnifier is working. Thank you. So yeah, I have to get that research done, and I have to get it done soon, because I need to print out a whole bunch of stuff for, like, very soon. Brown Owl actually was like, yes, when you come to the parade on Saturday, you need to check in with Snowy Owl. And I'm like, yeah, except for Snowy Owl doesn't have the ability to print off a sheet for you to sign in and out. So, we're not quite sure how you're going to do that. I may have to old school it and sit there with a ruler and a piece of paper and go that way. So yeah, that's going to be a little interesting. There is no way I can get a printer between now and the weekend. I don't think so. Canada Post is on strike, and UPS are stupid. I will point blank say that because I really don't like them. They came to our apartment. They buzzed up to the apartment. We buzzed to let them in, and then they didn't show up. It's like, what? So, you know, we checked the lobby thing. They weren't here. They were gone. So I went online and I'm like, where are you? Like, we buzzed you in. So I was worried we had buzzed somebody in that wasn't actually, you know, them. And so it was a little worrisome. Oh, there's nothing wrong there. Okay, well, that is definitely wrong. That is wrong. I was about to nail that one, but there's nothing wrong with it. That is wrong. So yeah, I contacted them, and he had said that he was unable to get us. I'm like, we buzzed you in. How is that you unable to get us? Like, I am confused. You spoke to my father. Like, you actually talked to him. So I don't understand. Was he expecting us to come downstairs? Because all the other UPS drivers come up to your apartment. The delivery is to my apartment, not to my lobby. So now I have to go to the UPS store to pick up the package that they deliver at 7 when the store closes at 6:30. I am like, thanks, guys. Thanks a lot. So yeah. I ordered a lot of stuff for Black Friday, and that's the last piece. And that's the piece that we wanted the most. It's actually the transmitter for my parents. They want to be able to go and watch TV in their room. Both of them wear hearing aids. So they want to be able to watch TV from their bed without having the volume so loud that everybody in the neighborhood has to listen to it. And the TV is pretty far away from where they are. And I share a wall with it, which means that I'm closer to their television than they are, so it's going to disrupt me. So I got them some wireless headphones, Bluetooth ones. They're actually the same ones that I have, except for mine are blue, because when I got mine, they were on sale, and the blue ones were on sale. This time, the black ones are on sale, so we got the black ones. So they got them, and they are like, they're built the same way as, how would you put it, hearing aids. They go over the back of your ears, they're the sports ones. And then they still have a little wire, or not a wire, but a thing that connects them around so you can't lose the two pieces. So I kind of like that design for me, and it's a good design for them so that, you know, they don't lose them. So they have those. And then I have a transmitter that needs to actually attach to the television to send it to them. Now, I managed to get a transmitter that can actually do two. So they'll have... I know there's something in here. Aha, I saw it. Well, I can't say I managed to. TechBack managed to. We spent a great deal of time doing tech time for my parents. So, but we managed to get one that will do two of them. So they can both connect to it and they can listen in and they can watch TV together, which is kind of sweet because they're kind of like that. They're in their 70s and 80s. Dad's 75 and mom is 82. And they are still one of those couple-y couples. Like the other day they were... Mom was going to the bedroom and Dad was coming out of the bedroom and he wrapped his arms around her and gave her a great big hug. And I'm just like, aw. I want to do that when I'm old and gray. And they'll sit together and hold hands. They've been married for over 40 years now. Yeah, that bothers me when they toss stuff over the fence and do things like that, because I'm like, yeah, this stuff I bought is not cheap. It's kind of why I like having like a secure building, because they should be able to drop it off several different places, and they just don't seem to understand how to do that. Now, when Amazon delivers it as Amazon, it is actually pretty cool. Like, they come and they have a thing for it, and there's a whole process, which I really like. I also discovered where my nearest Amazon drop-off location is, and I'm thinking maybe I'd like to do that instead. And go pick it up myself. And do that. You guys are still... Aw. I would like to be... The problem is, it's hard to do when you live so far away. Oh, another surfboard. Yay. We live too far apart. But we do have our another fluffy rabbit. We do have our cute stuff. Things like our routines every night of saying goodnight and saying good morning. And if we're going somewhere, we do the whole drive safe, and there's lots of I love yous everywhere. And I mean, we're first together. There wasn't a whole lot of it publicly, like when we were streaming and stuff. Now, meh. I join his stream and I'm like, hi, hon. You know, that type of stuff. Like the whole thing is just, who cares? Everybody knows, so it's not like it's a secret or anything. Okay. We'll just go this way in general. Or not, because there's more of this... stupid. There's too much of it. I am going to comment on there about the fact that I know there's a post I have for reading. I have it saved to read after the stream. About the fact that there is so much of this stuff and it's really hard to break. Like, how do you break it? What angle do you need to hit it on to actually count to get rid of it? Because it is a colossal mess. There's another part of the welding helmet. The other part. We have part one. We need part two. Other than the relics in here, this contains every type of metal. So that's kind of awesome. And I'm pretty sure we did that one. I can't see what the other things are. Oh, okay. Those are those ones. I want to move back down here and take a look from here. What do we got? We have... All right. It would really like me to go... here. So I think I'm going to go here. I mean, it works because we're... Oh, hello, engine. We are working our way down in the correct direction. That is a pretty picture. That I like. Oh, and we didn't get to see it for very long. And apparently I've done this one already. Well, that would be sad. All right. But it's good to know. That's probably why it loaded so fast. I can't see. Now I can't see. How do you get the right angle on these pieces to get rid of them? Like, there's just no idea. Okay, headed this way. Yeah, I see the big pink dot, but I want to go this way. Looks like it's mostly junk. Parts, diving helmet. All right. Let's go this away. And jump again. There we go. Okay, so we have had that one before. You, my lone dot. And what's the other one? An advanced engine. All right, turning back around. We're headed to there. I don't really want to go towards the center, but I kind of don't have a choice. Time is it? Okay, it's time to do that. Keep going. We do have to keep an eye on our inventory, though. How close? Oh, we got it. And this away. Good. I want to go back that way. And more diving helmet pieces. All right. That works. Because if that's... Oh, no. This is a diving and that is a welding. All right. That's a silicone chip we don't care about. We We do need to get a little higher, though. Up. And got it. Then come back down because the other one... There. Not enough stamina. Just three nights away? No. I would like to think later on it'll be better, but for now we're stuck by circumstance. I don't have a lot of say in it. Ooh, French horse piece. I don't care about anything else. I want that. Yeah. It is hard. It is a lot of work. But I don't know. It's good. I do worry about him quite a bit. That's why when I go there, I drive him absolutely nuts because I'll cook up a storm and leave a ton of food in the freezer. And I fill up his cabinets full of food. He's like, you're spending all my money on food. And it's like, but it's all food to make sure he has food in the house to eat so he's not eating out all the time. And it's all the stuff, like I'm trying to do all the stuff I would do if I was there. I kind of feel guilty that there's things that I should be doing, but I'm not doing. Did I make it look like me? I do not have pink hair. My hair is actually dark blue in real life. I think skin tone wise, I have mixed Caribbean blood, so my skin tone is seasonal. Depending on, oh my gosh, we definitely have to come back to this corner. So this is the bottom right corner. But there isn't enough time to actually search for anything, so I am just going to use up my stamina getting medals. Am I really out of... How do I have not enough stamina? I have three. It takes two. I feel cheated. So I went with the closest skin tone to what I have. In the summer, I get a lot darker. In the winter, I get a lot lighter. I have kind of an olivey sort of Mediterranean skin tone. Yes, it was blue when I first started in the game. It was blue. It was a little bit longer when I started the game. I have cut my hair since, so... It is shorter. This is closer to the length of my hair, but not the color of my hair. And actually, yeah, that would be the length of my hair, but I have a natural curl in it. So this is not curly enough to represent my hair. Like it's way not curly enough. Yay, more junk. But yeah, I changed it to pink. I did a big pink updo for my wedding when I married. And I've kept it ever since. Today's a rainy day. Today would be a good day to find Ginger. She should be traveling. Although, I should take a look in here. Okay, we still have lots of space. But no, if you do exclamation point, I think it's FB for Facebook, you will see what I actually look like because I have pictures there. Hi, Ginger. No, I'm not going to watch where I'm going because I am trying to interact with you and you will not interact with me. Yep. And... So yeah, there are pictures of me and Tackback and other streamers that I have met throughout time. I don't think I've tagged the other streamers, though. Not as far as I recall. I might have, but I don't know if I tagged them so much as I may have said this is who they are. I have been to the meetup in Atlanta, so I've met other Atlanta streamers. Even though I'm not an Atlanta streamer, I have actually met Atlanta streamers. Yeah, and it has things like when we went to PAX, it has when we went to... It's Warren Fur that I need. We went to Dragon Con, which is handily enough in Atlanta. And where else did we go? Oh, we just came back from vacation. We went to Barbados to see my family. And then we went back to Atlanta and we went to Savannah, Georgia, because I didn't believe him that they had beaches. And apparently they do. Although we went on an incredibly windy and cold day. So that was interesting. We brought our bathing suits, but we're like, yeah, no, not going to happen. Way, way too cold and way too windy. There was just not going to happen. And then we did Dragon Con again. I really enjoy Dragon Con. And the more I go to it, the more I get involved. This year we spoke a lot to different panel stuff. We go a lot to the more educational stuff on how to be a better streamer and how to, you know, do social media. We do a lot of that type of panels because there's a lot of educational content there. Not just seeing the stars, because of course we did go see Gina Torres, but you can't miss Gina Torres. We had planned on going to the parade, but we didn't really have any seats or anything, and sitting on the concrete was just terrible. And we discovered that if you went into the hotels have a live feed of the parade. So we sat in really comfy, puffy chairs and watched the parade from inside. So I was like, yeah, I kind of like that better. So yeah, I'm going to be kind of mail it in. I am a little upset with myself because 2 years ago, Stan Lee was there and I didn't make an effort to go and see him. I knew that the year he came to Toronto, which was the year before I went down there, that year I could have seen him here and I was like, eh. I'm not such a big superheroes and that type of, you know, the whole Marvel world, and I'm not such a big fan of that. I am a sci-fi geek. I like, you know, Doctor Who. That's more my stream of things. I like Lost in Space. I like that type of stuff. Like, I'm more of a pure science, not a fantasy science. Although my favorite author is technically a fantasy science fiction writer. That's what your science... Huh? That they're also a fan of pure science? Like, I read Isaac Asimov and Robert Heinlein and stuff like that. I am a huge fan of the pure sciences. I mean, some of the stuff I follow on YouTube is true science geek stuff. Yeah. To give an idea, I watched the new... For the life of me, I can never remember its name. I think it's Inspire. Yeah, I watch Inspire land on Mars. And that, to me, is thrilling. Like, that is exciting. People are like, it's another rover. I'm like, No, I follow the Rovers on Twitter. I sing them happy birthday and stuff. They are important parts of my life. It's sad, but true. Okay, so we did come up here. We hit F, and there was a billion things in front of us, and now there are not. You know what? There were a billion things, but we didn't bother to check to see if there are actually good things. We just knew there were things. But yeah, I am a big fan of science. I love to learn. I love all that type of stuff. But superhero stuff to me is... it is the suspension of belief, but it's not enough. I don't know. I enjoy it for what it is. Pure entertainment. But it's like having chocolate cake. Chocolate cake is delicious, but enough chocolate cake and you're going to puke. So, yeah. I need a proper meal every so often of things that most other people would be like, that is so boring. I'm like, no, really. It's interesting. It is hugely interesting to me. Yeah, there's no real science to it. There's no... it's like, yeah, they're from outer space. Yeah, that doesn't make it science. Like, it really, really doesn't. So yeah, I am a huge geek in that way. I'm also like, oh, poor Tackback. He finds it so funny. We've passed a water treatment facility. I'm like, look at that. Oh my gosh, look at that. I'm so excited about a water treatment facility. He's like, it's where they pump sewage. I'm like, I know. Isn't that awesome? I wonder what technique they're using. And I am like totally all gaga over water treatment. That is something I love. I love stuff like that. I love... water treatment was actually what I wanted to do for a living. I actually wanted to do... work in a water treatment facility. And it is an issue here, surprisingly, in Canada, being a first world country. We have a lot of communities who are on boiled water advisories, because there aren't enough people working in the actual treatment facilities to run them. And the problem is where they are. Nobody wants to live where you have to fly in. Eggs are $5 an egg. $5 an egg. Do you want to live somewhere where it's $5 to have a single egg? I'm like, I don't think I could do that. Hence why I do not live in those communities. But that's why they don't have anybody to look after their water treatment, because nobody wants to live there. They do have a program now, which is exciting for me, and it's one that my church actually sponsors, in which we are training the locals, because it's mostly on Aboriginal places that we have this problem. When you live in the north of nowhere and you have a beautiful, shiny, water treatment facility, nobody wants to live in the middle of nowhere. So you have to train the people who live there already to do it. And they're doing that now, which is really cool. And so a lot of communities are coming off of boiled water onto actual water, which is cool. Okay, what about Star Wars? I am a Trekkie, tried and true. I was raised on Star Trek, actually, Star Trek and Doctor Who. My dad is a science geek as well. He is what has taken me into this direction. He's the one who corrupted my mind by teaching me things. He is a fan of Star Trek, so that is what I was introduced to first. I don't even think he's watched the Star Wars. I have watched them. And Again, they are not very accurate. I find Star Trek to be far more accurate. It's accurate in the same way that they're trying to extrapolate from whatever we have going on now in the world. What could it look like then? And the nice thing is that it is so realistic that, how do I put it? We actually are creating the things that they have in there. Tricorders are not unheard of. We have the cell phones. We have all of the tech that they had then. We have this stuff. And it's our normal. But back then, that'd be unheard of. But that's the thing. It isn't actually more work, and it doesn't really cost too much more money. It's just not interesting. Facts are boring. So if you're trying to make a movie and you're trying to make a blockbuster, you've got to create the force. Well, really? Like, that's not a thing. Like, so it's going to make it a little tough. I don't know what that thing is down there. I wonder if that's a room. It's not a thing that we can actually create. And yeah, that's just not okay. Lightsabers and stuff like that. Yeah, at Dragon Con, they had a whole selection of them that you could get. None of them were actually lightsabers. They're just sticks with tubes and little lights inside of them. So it's pure fantasy. My cell phone is a communicator from out of Star Trek. So it's real. Star Trek is very, very real. At least it was real when Gene Roddenberry was in charge. I can't say much for any of the new stuff. Star Trek Destiny or Discovery or whatever they're calling it, because it's a nightmare. I don't quite know what it's supposed to do or where it's supposed to take place, but it is an everlasting disaster. I think it went 2 seasons, but I would not put money on that. I watched... In Canada, it was free. You could watch it here for free without any issues each week, and it was on demand. The thing is, how do you stop the plasma? You would have an infinite line, which means you'd be cutting holes through everything and everyone, including the Earth. There'd be a lot of chopped up pieces. Our planet would look pretty messy. The problem with the plasma and the problem with lasers and problems with that is that it's an infinite line. So you need to have somewhere in some way to stop them. I'm like, why isn't this working? Because you're pressing the wrong button. So there's science issues with them, which is where I have a problem. And you have to be of a certain type of person to get them to even really work. So if you don't have the force, you can't even really use a lightsaber. It's not like anyone can just pick it up and use it. You have to have a certain type of power. And that I don't like. In Star Trek, everyone picks up a communicator and uses it. Like, the science works. Why can't I get piece 2? Is there something against me getting piece 2? Have I offended the people who designed this? Game designers, where is my part 2? Thank you? See, I have offended them. Because they have provided me part 2 in the last possible thing. I don't know a lot about electromagnets, I will say for that. That is something I am not as reliably knowledgeable on. Just let me have this. Thank you. And then diving helmet piece one would be great too. Thank you. I don't think I'll have enough stamina. Let's try one of these. May run out of time first. Well, at least let me get the box. Can I? Nope. Oh, so close. Yeah, I don't know how the plasma would react to electromagnets, because you know what's going to happen tonight.